These things are kind of exhausting. Hopefully the end result will be worth it.
Have you ever wondered how fashion influencers create those cool transitions? I mean, there's the basics, like teleporting. But today, I would like us to try one that's a little more interesting and a little more complicated. My name's Grace. I'm a videographer and content creator for small businesses, and I'm here to teach you the basics of content creation.
There's no gatekeeping on this channel, so let's get into it.
Okay, so there's this trend that's going around, and it's effective because of the before and after moment. It's a very simple trend, though. Right now, it's like very easy to do.
Anna, hurry up!
What? I'm ready.
I would like to take the trend and elevate it a little bit. So instead of it just being the going behind a closed door and then popping back out, I want to see what happened in that magical moment behind the closed door. How did Anna change that quickly? That is the question that we want to answer. One of my favorite fashion transitions that's still very simple, but it is a little bit more complicated than the one that we just looked at, is the falling on the bed transition. I think it would be fun to incorporate the falling on the bed transition to this behind the door transition with that specific audio. Yes, the video will be a little bit more complicated to make, but that's the point of this video. I'm going to make it right alongside with you, so you're going to be able to see every step of the process, and if there's a problem, we will troubleshoot it. So let's get into it.
What you're going to need for this transition is your phone, a tripod, a bed, two outfits, and we are going to use the editing app CapCut. Because we're filming like a before and after situation, it is crucial that the tripod does not move between those moments. If we move the tripod, the magic of the transition is lost, and that's because it changes the background, and then there's like a mismatch of where everything is in the two clips. I have the camera in the corner of the room because I want to see as much of the bed as possible for the transition. And right now I do have the curtains partially open, but that's something we need to pay attention to. It's very important that you're not too backlit, and by that I mean that the light isn't behind us too much, because if the light is behind us, we end up looking much darker in the shot. And really the main focus, of course, of this shot is me. It's not the room. So even if the room looks a little bit like not as nice because I've pulled the curtains, it's more important that you can see me properly. So we're gonna have a look at that. The plan is, for my first clip, I'm going to run in, jump on the bed, right? So there needs to be some space here. Pretending that I'm running into the room, frantic. That's gonna be the moment. Now I'm going to check to see how that looked. Okay, so here's a flaw. The door has to be closed, and right now you guys are in the door, so I need to change up where you are. Okay, so now that I have my shot all lined up, I have my first outfit on, I have my second outfit ready to go, because my intention is to shoot the whole thing just in one running clip. I don't want the exposure or the focus or anything like that to change between the two clips, so I'm going to do like a speed wardrobe change in between.
My camera is in the corner over there.
Something else I forgot to mention is that I'm going to do each part at least three times so that we've got options. Okay, so obviously we want there to be a wardrobe change. I'm not wearing a dress or anything because I have a feeling the dress is gonna fling up a little bit if I do. So I'm just wearing like a jumpsuit. You need something that's dramatic. So taking the glasses off, take my hair down, and a different outfit. This is the first time that it's gonna get a little bit tricky because we have to think backwards. Everything we do now, we have to think backwards because this clip is going to be reversed, so it looks like we're popping up from the bed rather than dropping onto it. I am going to start by looking pleased with myself, nodding, and then backing up onto the bed and dropping onto it. I draw the line at getting up. Gen Z that does these fancy things. It hurts the back. It's a little too, well, hurts a little too much for millennials maybe. Okay, so we filmed the first two segments, but we're not going to film the last part of the video yet because I need to lip sync the line that's in the last part of the video. Like there's the cat.
What do you want?
That is because in the third clip we are lip syncing, so we need to record that within the Reels or Instagram app so that we get the lip sync lined up perfectly. So first we need to actually edit the first two parts together so that we have that complete, can import that into Reels and TikTok, get the timer set up, and lip sync. So we are here in CapCut. This is my clip and ended up being super long. We're just gonna add that right into the timeline. Go ahead and mute it so that it's not bothering you. Split the clip here, delete the beginning, and see how this looks. Not bad. Trim the clip so that you are in the air right before landing. Split here. So now I'm going to scrub across to where I finally get changed. See how the light, nothing has changed on us, which is good. So you're gonna split the clip and delete all the empty dead space in between. And here we've got our, what's going to be our reverse clip. Delete the ending. Now we're going to select the second part of our clip, scroll across the bottom. Where is it? Reverse. Here is where the magic happens. It's pretty clean already. So I'm just playing around with my options here. So this is, I'm gonna do this, hold the clip, drag it across so that I've got two different options. So here's the first one. Okay, I'm gonna exit out of that for now, and I'm going to duplicate the project before I delete any of the clips, because if we have to go back and change anything, it's very annoying to have to reverse everything again. Delete. So once you have everything lined up exactly as you want it lined up, you can see here that I was trying to get it the motion perfect so that as I landed on the bed, I popped right back up like magic. I'm going to export. Okay, so now that we have edited those first two clips together, the next step is to open up TikTok or Instagram, whichever one you're gonna record within. I'm using Instagram today, but you can, if you decide to use TikTok, you can just go to the search engine and search Anna Hurry Up When I'm Ready, and the sound is gonna come up for sure. If you are editing this within Instagram, you can do the same thing, you can just search for it. Now, the last clip is going to be me opening up the door and saying, what, I'm ready. So I need to have the camera on the tripod outside the door. I'm going to crank the volume on this so that I can hear exactly when I need to open the door and say like when I'm ready. So I've got the tripod, I have my audio within Instagram, I'm going to press use audio, import, actually no, I'm not going to import any clip yet. I'm going to press on the camera option so I can see myself. I'm going to flip it around so that we are using the front facing camera. Clean the lens, folks, always clean the lens. Set it up on the tripod. I am going to be going inside this room beyond the door, but first I want to have this, make sure that it's lined up. So here we are. Press the timer when you're ready. I feel like I wasn't quick enough, so I'm going to record again. I'd rather have more room to play with. Anna, I'm ready. The problem with the timing is that the door opens inward and it doesn't really, I can't get out fast enough and line up the sound with the door opening. But we're gonna try one more. Thank you. ready. These things are kind of exhausting. Hopefully the end result will be worth it.
That concludes today's transition tutorial. It did come with a few trials and tribulations, but we got there in the end. If you have any questions about the process or if you get stuck at one of the steps, feel free to leave the question in the comments below and I'll try to get back to you. And if you are looking for more tips on video editing, go to my profile. I've got a whole bunch of YouTube shorts on the topic. Thanks for watching and hope to see you soon.